Hello everybody, this is Mr. Fire, and here we have one new build for Titan Quest Anniversary Edition plus Ragnarok plus Atlantis. This build I call the Retaliation SS build. Retaliations build. And it is a summon class. What is the idea of this build? Of course, this is a dual mastery build, not single mastery build. The next single mastery build we will see the next Sunday, 3 days from today, or 2 days from, I think 3 days from today, where we will be talking about a new single mastery build, but this is a dual mastery build. It is the class Summon, which plays with Spirit Mastery and Rune Mastery as well. This is my controversial bow build. Why controversial bow build? Because, first of all, the idea of this build, I should say that this build is somewhat an experimental build. I'm trying to do an experiment here or something like that. And the idea is to play with a bow, but to have to rely very heavily on retaliation damage. Damage retaliation and also, in general, retaliation effects, such as life leech retaliation, energy leech retaliation, damage retaliation, and whatnot. It is all about retaliations. Of course, we have already, about 2 years ago, I made another retaliation build. That was the electricity build. It was a successful, very nice build. But this one is very different than that one. Because that one was playing with a sword and a shield, this plays with a bow. And actually, the gameplay of this build is to rely heavily on letting enemies hit you, close combat, to hit you, so that they can, with melee attacks to hit you, so that the retaliations that you have on this character will trigger on the melee attacking enemies, and this way we defeat enemies faster. So, this is the idea of the build. This is why I call it controversial, because when you play bow builds normally, you try to kill your enemies by using your bow, so from a distance you don't want your enemies to come close to you and hit you. But with this bow build, you want enemies to come and hit you. At least melee attacker enemies, because retaliations work only with melee attacks. Ranged attacks do not trigger retaliation effects. So, this is why this build is controversial. Let's check out the skills. For the skills, I will use my controller, because here we have a small problem. So, in Spirit Mastery, I'm playing with Deathchill Aura, of course. I'm playing with Ravages of Time, which is awesome. And Deathchill Aura is awesome. It reduces total speed of enemies, even though you will think now, okay, melee attackers come close to you, they hit you, and you want retaliations to work on them and kill them. So, do you really want to reduce their total speed? The question is no, not really. But it is not damage reflection, it is damage retaliation. So many effects of damage retaliation are overtime effects. They only have to hit you once to receive damage retaliation. So it is not such a big of a problem as it would be if we were playing with damage reflection. You know, damage reflection and damage retaliation are two similar effects, but not the same. They work a bit differently. And here we have the Necrosis, which is very powerful. It reduces the bleeding vitality and life leech resistances of enemies. Which means now that not only against enemies that hit you with melee attacks, but all types of enemies. Enemies that get affected by Deathchill Aura. I have also maxed out the Death Ward. This skill is for every build that you play with Spirit. You want this skill because it helps with survivability very much. It will keep you alive. I have this skill. I am using Life Drain, of course, for survivability and damage vitality. This one Cascade, and this one here, vitality damage again, damage to ghosts, and all of these things. Reduction to enemy's health. Here we have the Spirit Ward and the Spirit Bane. These skills are mandatory. They help very much against undead. And here we have the Circle of Power, which is maxed out at on +3. We want to have this one maxed out because of the recharge reduction that we get when we activate this one. The more life leads, 100% life leads, vitality damage, and bleeding damage, all of these things help very much when you stay in the radius of effect of the circle of power. And in Rune Mastery, I'm having this one, Rune Weapon. I would like to max out this one, Rune Weapon, but later. This was not very important because, again, this is a retaliation build. So, which skill is the most important from all of the skills of Rune Mastery? This one. Magical Charge. When you hit one enemy with this one and you charge this attack, you have only one charge level, then this one triggers. This one doesn't scale with how many charge levels you have. Only one charge level is enough for this one to trigger at its full capacity. Which means, I hit one enemy with this one, I gain one charge level, and then this one is active now, and this one deals elemental damage when I hit enemies with my bow. But it also activates elemental retaliation, and every time now that melee attackers hit me, they receive this elemental retaliation back. This is why it is so important, because this is a retaliation build, and you got this effect to be active all the time if possible. And yes, all the time you attack enemies with your rune weapon and bow, but you do not rely very much on killing enemies with your bow, unless these enemies, of course, are raged enemies or even big bosses that can kill you very easily, so you don't go to get hit many times by big bosses, you try to avoid their attacks. And we have a point here. I will probably increase the level of this one much later. Now it is not that important. This was the most important, the Magical Charge. I have some points here. This is maxed out. I don't need the Rune Word Feather because I play with a bow. I have Thunder Strike maxed out, of course, at the Addon Unleash. This is very important, it's very powerful as a skill, and it works very nicely with bows as well. And I have this skill here, Rune of Life, which is maxed out. And of course it helps very much. So, this is the skill setup of this build for now. This is Legendary difficulty, by the way. Let's change again back to keyboard and mouse. Here we are. I have all of my skills down here. Energy armor, and this is legendary difficulty. When it comes to attribute points, I have spent a few points on energy because I needed more energy to be able to cast some of the skills, energy armor mostly. And I spent the rest of my points on intelligence and dexterity. I haven't spent points on strength or health. And we have a nice amount of health points right now because of the full setup of items that we have. And intelligence is not the greatest number, but it is okay because when we start attacking with rune weapon, we gain recharge levels. Charge levels increase our intelligence by 30% at level 3, at least. And it also increases total damage and elemental damages. Total damage doesn't increase retaliation damage. Retaliation damage is something different. It doesn't belong to total damage. But it doesn't really matter because it increases other types of damage, and it is awesome. And strength is useless because we don't try to play a physical damage build, and we don't try to equip items that require lots of strength. So, this is it. You can see here my average damage and damage per second. I tried to make a setup of items which would give me, of course, the best resistances possible, and this is what I came up with. And of course, items that would provide me with damage retaliation effects. In general, retaliation effects, not only damage. For example, this one provides also energy leech retaliation, which deals zero damage to enemies, but it is a nice effect to get more energy out of your enemies when they hit you, melee attackers. And my only bad resistance is this one, fire. Fire resistance is very bad. This is good, not perfect, good. The rest of my resistances are very good. And of course, this is 60%, this is 80, but if I trigger my Rune of Life, which provides both bleeding and vitality resistances, then this one goes up to 80%. So, the resistances of this build are very good, in general. The defensive ability now is also very, very good, 955. Offensive ability is useless, this is a bow build. Defensive is perfect. So, the build is not a glass cannon build. It is a good build when it comes to survivability. Now, when it comes to items, these are the items I'm using. Glorybringer. Why? Because of the completion bonus mostly, 41% burst resistance. If I take it off, it goes down to 36. And of course, I lose some resistances here in the metal. It is 8%. But this is also very good because of the less damage from undead demons and also plus one on skills. And you know, in the game there are many undead and many demon enemies. So this item helps very much right now here. And for now I'm using this one. Maybe later I will think of another item which would be better than this one probably. But this pierce resistance completion bonus is very important. I am using this one, the Ethereal Cage. This is a Mastery Frequent that drops from some hero ghosts. And maybe it drops only from ghosts. When we say ghosts, we are talking about ghostly undead zombies. Ghost zombies, not ghosts, ghosts. But ghost zombies. And for example, Alastair, the boss Alastair in the Catacombs of Athens, can drop this item. And this one was a very nice drop because, as you can see, I get resistances and I also get Life Leech Retaliation and Energy Leech Retaliation. So, the reason I'm using this one is first because it is a Mastery Frequent and I can enchant it with a Relic or a Charm. And second, of course, because I get Life Leech and Energy Leech Retaliation, which is, of course, the point of the build. Now, I decided to equip here the Charm of Atlantis Act, which is a special charm. This charm provides this chance of lightning resistance, which is very nice to have. And it also says 17% chance of lightning retaliation, stun retaliation, health reduction retaliation, which is absolutely awesome, as we can see. This Charm of Atlantis is absolutely amazing. It is very powerful. And you can enchant only chest armor items and shields with this Atlantean Artifice Charm. Of course, I'm not using any shields right now, but it was a great idea to have this charm on a green item for this build. And this item is awesome for this build. And it also looks great, as we can see. The looks of this item are truly amazing. I just love it. And it looks very fitting to this skull here, and maybe to the bow and the leggings. It is very nice. So, here we have the Crest of Hypnos. This is classically the best helmet in the game when it comes to resistances. Not only intelligence-based helmet, but in general. It is the best helmet in the game when it comes to resistances because it provides so many resistances. Actually, I think it provides all types of resistances, primary ones, and many types of secondary ones. So it is absolutely powerful and it looks great, especially in combination with this one. By the way, it is not upgraded and it is okay. Here we have the Band of Souls. This one again provides some resistances. This is an upgraded one. This is why it provides me with cold resistance a little bit. And the upgrade also gave me something else which I cannot remember right now. I did not see. It was a great upgrade because this 25% cold resistance is added here. And I have only 63%. So if I take it off, it goes down to 38. Which is awesome. Very awesome item. And it helps very much with vitality resistance. Here I have the Star of Elysium. Why? Because of the resistances it provides mostly and the health. Health, resistances, health regen. All of these things are very important. You know, every time when I make a new build, I always use on my new builds items that I have already found and kept in my collection of items. I don't have all of the items of the game in my collection, so there are probably some different setups you can make for this build, for example, that are better than this setup because they give you maybe more resistances or more stats and whatnot for this specific build. But from all of the items that I had in my collection, this is what I could come up with so far. And I'm using the Star of Elysium, which is a very powerful ring in general in the whole game. Here we have, and let's go down here, Leggings of the Defiled. This item is awesome as well. It is one of the best leggings for intelligence builds because of the resistances and also defensive ability it provides in total damage, awesome item. Here we have the Bronze Heart of Talos. I'm using this one for the plus 43% health, the plus 1 to all skills of course, energy regen, defensive ability 22%, and I have also upgraded this one. The upgrade gave me 23 strength and minus 12% reduction to all requirements. This was a normal difficulty upgrade, not an epic difficulty. So, it is okay. Okay, the strength, the 23 strength is totally useless for this build. But anyway, what can you do? This is what I got and this is what I have. Here we have the Armlets of Riga, one very powerful item for as a bracer item for intelligence based builds with many resistances and also defensive ability, recharge reduction, plus 5 to Seal of Fate, which I'm not using currently, by the way. I don't know if I will use it later, we will see, because the idea is to play the retaliation build. Even though this Seal of Fate could help greatly, probably with its add-on, which reduces resistances of enemies, and when you trigger this one in front of you and enemies are in front of you, it helps very much killing enemies. But we will see, I don't know. This item is very powerful and it is very nice having this item on this build. Knit Bow. Super powerful bow. One of the most powerful bows in the game, we could say. Why am I using this one? Because energy leech, life leech over time, 30% total damage, very good base physical damage, very nice pierce ratio, which I don't care about, vitality damage, a big number. Every time you attack with this bow, with the rune weapon attack, you apply life leech, energy leech, and also you deal vitality damage, the numbers we see here. You also apply reduced resistances to your enemies. And when, we can see also that this item comes with retaliation effects. 22% health reduction retaliation, which is similar to this one, 40% health reduction retaliation. They stack. 62% energy leech retaliation and slowed attack retaliation. So I decided to go with this one because it provides all of these very nice stats, including the three retaliation effects. And here we have it. This is the build right now, and it is a very nice build. Let's see, secondary, what do we have here? We have star resistances 45, slow down 47, 80% sleep, 80% energy resistance, and disruption resistance 41%. My secondary resistances are very good. I would like this one to be not zero, because this one can kill me actually. Even though sometimes, if enemies trap you with a net, and this net reduces your defensive ability, there is a good chance you will get killed. Even though my defensive ability is in a very good state right now, almost 1000, which is very good. You need about 800 in legendary difficulty to be certain that you will not get wrecked by melee attackers with critical damage. Of course, there are some exceptions, big bosses and some other hero enemies, but in general, 800 is enough. 1000 is very good. This is a build. You can see that when I trigger the energy armor, we lose lots of energy. Let's trigger this once, and let's go trigger this one as well. Let's go kill a couple of enemies so that you can see gameplay. This was the Thunder Strike. My attacking speed is also not good enough, but we see I hit this enemy once and I kill it. Zack. Let's see now. Yeah, retaliation is killing these enemies now. We can see how much we energy leech them, and we can see that he hits me and he gets killed because of my retaliation effects. And also, I forgot to tell you about this skill, this one. You see these meteor-like effects, they come from the bow, it is a power strike activated on attack. This skill has 0 recharge, 0 seconds recharge, it has no cooldowns. Which means when you attack, this one triggers, usually. And it is a very powerful attack because it also provides 100% of attack damage compared to health. So, what you want to do with this build is, of course, hit some enemies, and when you fight bosses, of course, when we fight bosses, we cannot rely only on damage retaliation, we have to attack all the time with the bow as well. Which means that this effect triggers all the time, almost. Okay, this effect doesn't have 100% chance to trigger. It is only the cooldown that is zero. There is no cooldown, I mean. And here we use this one, which is the Thunder Strike. Let's see more enemies, please. Yes, now they hit us with melee attacks. These two guys are not melee attackers. We have also the life drain skill. This one hits us and he goes down. This is the build. The build is all about letting enemies come close to you, melee attackers, because raged enemies will never get close to you. And let them hit you with their melee attacks, so that they can trigger the retaliation effects on them and get killed this way. And of course, when they hit you and you have this 40% health reduction retaliation here, and you have the 22% health reduction retaliation here, then we can see that these two effects, they destroy enemies. This one, the 22% health reduction retaliation, works all the time. Every time melee attackers hit you. This one, the 40%, doesn't work all the time because it belongs to this 17% chance of one of these three. So, the 40% health reduction retaliation has actually a small chance. It is about maybe 17% chance of these three. It is maybe 5% chance per attack for this one to trigger. Maybe something like that. Per attack of enemy. So, an enemy attacks you, there is a 5% chance for this 40% health reduction retaliation to trigger. But this one triggers for every attack of the enemy. 22% health, standard. So, it is very nice as a combination. Guys, this is the build. Leave comments below, let me know how you feel about this build. If you can recall some items that could benefit this build even more, that I cannot remember right now, because I forget very easily. In tomorrow's live stream, I will be live streaming this build. We will have gameplay of this build, and you will see, we will see all together how this build performs in Legendary. So, this is it, guys. Everybody, thanks for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe. We have lots of Titan Quest content coming up in this channel, and I will see you super duper very soon again. Have fun.